Welcome back to Mailbag Monday. Today's openings begin with Star Beast Imperial Stout from Sucrum's Brewing in Winnipeg. They describe it as a complex and full-bodied Imperial Stout with hints of dark chocolate molasses and a resinous hops bite. Dark, rich, and robust. Oh, wow. That does have a strong taste to it. I like it. Look at all the packages over here. Let's get busy. This first one is described as solder wire. That's exactly what it is. A small spool of solder. It is 6337. Okay. So not your standard 6040. I'm not sure exactly what it means, but I believe I've read that 6337 is described as a eutetic mix. But I'm no metallurgist, so I'm not that sure what that really means. Anyway, it certainly feels like solder. Where's that other roll of cheap Chinese stuff that I had back here somewhere? That's the good stuff. That's MG Chemical. It's much stiffer. That is not as stiff. It's also finer. Here's that other crappy Chinese stuff. Yeah, it does feel very similar. Different brand name, though. And again, that's a 6437. It's a 6337. I wonder what the extra percentage there is. Anyways, let's just see. I'm assuming... Oh, yeah, it does that. It smokes pretty good, which tells me that it's got a reasonable amount of flux in it. And again, so does that one. But that one just goes to town. And this guy, being thicker, has more room for the flux in it. Let's just cut this at a bit of an angle and see if we can see it with the magnifying glass here. I mean, there is some flux core in there. Maybe I'll give this stuff a try just for the hell of it. Said I remember that this didn't have enough flux in it to do anything useful. But I do have some extra flux that I can add on if I have to. It's just a bit of a pain. I'm much happier using this. But this was probably really cheap. And it better be for such a tiny little reel too. I figured I'd gamble. Let's see what I paid for it. One piece tin lid rosin core solder soldering welding iron wire 0.8 millimeter reel flux 2%. I got this for 54 cents American or 68 cents Canadian at auction for that kind of a price, free shipping. I figured it was worth the gamble, even if it's crap. I mean, it's worth the gamble, but you never know until you know, and then you know. I got it from WinWinGo. And it looks like the only way they still have solder in their store is in this three rolls for $4 plus $3 shipping. So that's no good at all. I'll link you to a search that for the keywords, so it'll find you something cheaper if you actually want to go down the road of gambling on cheap Chinese solder. I wouldn't recommend it, but sometimes, yeah, who knows, gamble might pay off. Let's see what's next. This one came from the Canadian reshipping warehouse, so there's no lies on the package for customs. That is a cable. It is USB to SATA, USB 3 specifically, note the blue color. At least it's supposed to be what blue means. And that is SATA for hard drives. So, my son and I have been doing a fair bit of tinkering around with our assorted computers, and it's just seemed like it would make a lot of sense to be able to transfer files easily and quickly between machines and stuff. So that is what that's for. It's also good for testing drives and stuff like that without having to open up the case. You never know when that's going to come in handy, but I think it will, and it probably would have already if I'd already had it. USB 3.0 to SATA hard drive adapter cable, SATA to USB 3.0 converter for HDD 2.5 inch, or really any SATA device I would expect. Got this from LCD Screen Wholesales. Paid $3.87 and 38 cents shipping. That's not unreasonable. It was obviously the cheapest price I could find at the time, so there we go. Don't know that there's much to say about it down here. Works with operating systems, all these different devices, unbranded generic, just a lot of pictures. It should just plug and play, really. Supports up to 6 gigabits per second transfer speed. That's useful. It has an LED activity indicator. I'll have to look at that, I guess. Plug and play hot swap, backwards compatible to USB 2 or USB 1. Okay, that's good because my shop computer here doesn't have any USB 3 on it, I don't think. Supports various operating systems, yada, yada, yada. Okay. Next in we have description, cable. Okay, I'll try not to cut that. Ah, this is those little tiny JSTs that tend to be used for small lithium-ion batteries. Looks like I've got a bunch of male and a bunch of female ends. What is that? About 20 of each? Seems reasonable. Just a handy thing to have around for modifying things and whatnot. I've run into this previously where I didn't have the right connector. And I hate to not have the right connector. 20 sets Micro JST 1.25 2-pin male and female connector plugs with wires cables. Got these from Goodwill underscore Elfie. And I paid $2.70 Canadian, $2.77 Canadian with free shipping from China. I don't often see things on ebay.ca that are priced in Australian dollars. That's interesting. I also didn't know that Australian and Canadian dollars were so close to the same value. Does it say anything else down here? That's all the same. 28 gauge wire, 100 millimeters, aka 10 centimeters, 20 males and 20 females. Yeah. Nothing else to say about them. They're just connectors with wire on them. Next in is acceptor. What the hell is acceptor? Little module and a USB cable. Oh, it says GPS on it. GF071 GPS. It has a USB connector on it. Oh, if I'm not very mistaken, that is a SIM card slot. Little lanyard holes there, a couple other holes there. Other than that, not too much going on. GF07 Enhanced Magnetic Locator. What does this all say here? Wow. This is horrible English, of course. So it talks about GPS, it talks about phone, it talks about magnets, and it has a whole bunch of, wow. I'm gonna go to the listing and see if it has to say anything in better English than that, and then we can zoom in on the manual and laugh at it together. How's that sound? Mini GPS tracker, anti-theft device, smart locator, magnetic, GSM real-time tracking. Anyways, I paid $8.42 for this with free shipping from this guy. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that. You can see it as well as I can. I'll put a link to this like I usually do, although not sure how much I would recommend buying one of these or not. I'll do a teardown on it at some point in the future and just see what's inside it. Maybe give it a test if I think I can trust it not to, oh, I don't know, clone my SIM card or do anything nefarious like that. Report back to China what's going on inside my house. I don't know what it does yet. Claims it has GPS and LBS double tracking, whatever that is. Super magnetic force, two strong magnets, remote operation of mobile phone, real-time tracking. You need a working AIM card. Is that like SIM only spelled wrong? Perfect for tracking vehicles, teens, spouses, elderly persons, or assets. That's weird. I don't see it having an AC input at 110 to 220, 50, 60 hertz. Probably DC input since it's got a USB on it. It's got a 400 milliamp hour lithium ion battery in it. It says it'll stand by for 12 days and it'll run for 4 to 6 days. Continuous operation for up to 180 minutes. Back to the crap manual, I guess. Okay, so they didn't lie about it having a magnet. They did kind of lie about it being a super strong magnet, though. That's not very strong at all. The low inferior chip, the cost is low, quality is not guaranteed. I think that's all we need to say about it today. Teardown coming in the future. And the last thing in. This comes from Seed Studios. And I've got a pretty good idea of what it is because they told me that they were sending it. So I hope it is, in fact, what they said they were sending. Their own branded box. That's a nice touch that you don't get from a lot of Chinese sellers. So this is supposed to be a development board, a development platform. The Wio Terminal, or Wio Terminal. It runs on a SAMD51 chip at 200 megahertz. It's got 32 megabits of flash. It has 2.4 and 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi. That's cool. It has Bluetooth low energy. It has an LCD. It has USB. It has a micro SD card slot on it. It has an accelerometer. It has a microphone. It has a buzzer. Its GPIO pinout is compatible with a Raspberry Pi. Cool. It has some Grove connectors, digital analog I2C and serial, some buttons, 3 user programmables, and, that seems like it might be an interesting thing to play with. Let's see if I can get it out of the package, even. Come here. Well, destroy the package. I don't want to destroy the package. Should I rip it fast? There. I know people like that. Last time I did that fast, it really annoyed people. So anyways, what do we have? Oh, a little window in the back. There is the Raspberry Pi format GPIO connections. What do we got down in there? We got an SD card. We got 3 buttons on the top. A little slot over there. Not quite sure what that one is. There's 2 Grove connectors. There's a USB-C on the bottom. That is a little switch tape joystick, 4 directions and click. Looks like a little microphone or speaker grill there. USB-C cable. A replacement little joystick cap. That's nice. A little manual in here. My big fumbly fingers can't get that out. Oh, some stickers. A little sticker sheet with GPIO pinout sticker. For reference, I guess. That's cool. But more importantly, the manual. What's in the box? Terminal, cable, manual. Yep. I will need a computer with access to the internet. Got one of those. Power it up by connecting the USB. Connect the other end to a computer. Switch the power on. So that's it. That's off. That's on. And flip down there is reset. Okay. Okay, so how to turn it on, how to reset it, how to enter the bootloader mode, QR codes to get to some links on their website for MicroPython or Arduino. Okay, so it'll run either one of those. That's nice. We've already figured out what those connectors are. So here is the guts of it. I'll screenshot that and read it at your leisure if you'd like. But it's mostly what we already went through. The pinouts for the GPIO, showing what all's going on there. That's good. If it's got the same pinout as a Raspberry Pi, then I probably don't have to go through this because I think most of us are familiar with Raspberry Pis, at least a little bit. And then the same thing repeats in other languages. Well, let's just plug this into the computer and see what happens. There's a USB-C into the bottom there. Let's pull that down to the on position. Push left button to continue. Okay. It comes preloaded with a game that I suck at. I guess I have to hurdle over those resistors, I suppose. Well, this is going well. I'll have to find my resident gamer to actually play this little game here, I guess. So that's the jump button.
So here it is on Seed's website, WIO or Wio Terminal, AT7051 core with Realtek. Well, you can read that too. It's compatible with both Arduino and MicroPython. We saw that in the manual. The SAMD51 is quite a powerful little processor, actually. It's the first time I've played with one, so we'll have to dig into the specs a little bit more. But, I mean, the CPU running at 120 megahertz natively, and it can be overclocked, okay. The Realtek Bluetooth and Wi-Fi chip screen. It's got basically everything you need to make a neat little toy out of it. And it is $29.90. I'm assuming that is American dollars. They've got a bunch of learning documents and things down here too, which I'm going to have to take a look at. I'll probably do another video coming up in the next week or two, doing a deep dive into this thing, just playing with it and getting some of my own half-assed code onto it and just trying some different things, making the GPIOs do stuff. And, you know, that's interesting that it's actually got Grove connectors on it too. I've got a somewhere around here, I think another maker sent me a Grove starter kit module thing, so I might have to pull that out too. Grove is basically just the form factor of that interconnection, which is very beginner friendly. It's functionally, it's no different than Arduino pins or anything else, but it just gives you power and communication pins all in one spot to plug and play without having to mess around. Yeah, there it is there, Grove connectors. No jumpers or soldering, you just plug and play. Oh, that's interesting. It can be used as a USB on-the-go host or client. So it can, with the right software, it can emulate devices, or it can talk to devices. Well, I think I'm probably going to start off, though, with MicroPython, maybe Arduino, maybe CircuitPython. I'm not sure. Ah, we got a whole bunch of getting started links and stuff here, too. Okay. Lots of projects. I might just run through a couple of those just to see what goes on.
And there we have it. The contents of yet another Mailbag Monday haul. As always, quite the variety. So, shipping times. This GPS tracker, which may or may not be a complete ripoff, took 21 days to get here. The USB to SATA adapter took 19 days. The bundle of micro JST connectors took 37 days. And the cheap little, you know, 70-cent solder took 43 days to get here. That, I'm not sure if it's going to be useful. That's going to be a fun teardown. Stock. Hopefully that works if I've got a drive that's not trashed. And this is going to be a fun little exploration once I get a bit of time to spend in the documentation. So stay tuned for more about that guy. Stay tuned for a teardown on that guy. Thanks, as always, for watching. Thanks to Seed Studios for sending me this thing for review. Thanks again to my generous Patreon supporters who help me buy all this stuff and buy me a beer now and again. I truly appreciate that. Questions or comments down below in the comment section as usual. I will talk to you later. Mm-hmm.